I decided to come up with my brand name at Lux. I sat down, I walked this man through building this website. I did everything, came up with the formula. It just happened that my brand became a big success and he was working with me. You guys would notice that if you've ever bought anything from nimbatlux.com, the email on that account is not my email. It is his email. So all the emails go to him. He assured me that he would take care of the customer service. He would answer all the emails and he would take care of anything that happens with the orders and stuff. And I'm so sorry that I'm rushing through this. This man became very angry, and because he has an association with my brand and my website, first of all, he shut everything down. He locked me out of my website, and up to this day, I'm not able to see anything that's happening with my website. And before I even go any further, once again, I want to apologize to each and every one of you that has made an order that has not received your order. There is a I want to say 95 to 98% of you have received everything you've ordered from nimbatlux.com, but there is a few of you who have been affected by this. And unfortunately, I do not see the emails. I do not see the request of you guys asking me for your orders, especially if you put in a wrong address or didn't put in something right or your credit card. Those orders have been returned and there is no way for me to track them. There is no way for me to know who's affected. And it makes me feel so horrible because I have no control over this.
Hi guys, welcome back to Over the Top WME wife, mom, entrepreneur. And today I'm just going to bring you my little two cents again on a video that I came across. And my two cents is going to be based on business, specifically entrepreneurial mindset. Whenever I look at a video, I always try to see what can I learn from it? And if I was in the position, what would I do differently from a business standpoint, a business mindset? This video is from a YouTuber called Mercy Gono. She has amazing videos for about her breakup and the reason why she broke up. She brought up something that was just pretty alarming to me and something that I feel like a lot of up and coming business people or people who are doing their own business or just from a standpoint of looking at things of how to protect yourself a little bit better, no matter who it is, no matter the circumstances. She brought up the fact that one of the reasons why she broke up with her boyfriend is because she gave access of her email to her boyfriend, which is her email, which is connected to her business. And he decided to lock her out from the business because he has access to the email that is connected to the business. And that way she's not able to communicate with the customers directly, and customers has not been getting orders. So needless to say, her business is tied up due to the ex-boyfriend has made some choices that he wanted to take over. My two cents on this is, first and foremost, guys, understand that we have to make sure we secure our business from any outside threats. We're gonna have people that hopefully you don't have to experience it, but it is a possibility that we're gonna have security threats within our business. People are gonna hack our stuff. It happens. What we could do is we can make sure we take measures and steps to protect that. Mercy Gunu had given her access to her email to her boyfriend. That is a huge, huge mistake. Not because she gave it to her boyfriend, just for the fact that only she gave her heart of her company. And I repeat, the heart of her company to access, 100% access to someone else. Now, you might be thinking, hey, what do you mean by she gave her heart of her company to someone else? I'm going to explain. Are you guys actually ever think about how important your email is? Your email, not your email that you use to conversate with family and friends and all that stuff. We're talking about your email that is connected to your business. If you think about it, when you sign up for certain things, that is one of the first things that they will ask, your email. Because no matter how times change, your access to directly get to someone is through email. Now, you could mail letters, but that's not actually as efficient. Having your email is connected to so many things that you might not have ever even given a thought to. Her email connected to her business and connected to her website. That email is a way for her to connect to her customers. It sends out email blasts. If she needs to tell her customers any changes to the website, any changes to the product, if she's making any sales, trying to promote any sales, she's sending out emails to her customers. Once the customer purchased something, that, depending on what platform you have, most of them, that platform connects back to the email. So therefore, whenever a customer purchased something, you have their email, so they can therefore communicate anything back and forth to them. That's where they could say, well, their purchase has been made, or if shipping needs to be updated and anything that needs to be done. That is the heart of the business, and the heart of the business is connected to the customer. Without you having customers, you don't have a business. So I hope you guys kind of understand now why I correlate saying that your email is the heart of your business. So if Mercy Gunu gives an entire access to someone else of her email to someone else that is connected to her business, that person is doing exactly what he's doing now. He controls everything and she cannot do anything about that. So this is a lesson to learn. If you're in business, you can add other people on to your email through other third-party providers that they can have limited access to your email. So they can help manage. There's different third parties out there. There's Asana. They have limited access where they could be on board as a manager, not entire access to where they can take over your entire company. That was something that I picked up on and I said, oh no, that was absolutely the first step that she went wrong. I don't care how great of a relationship it was. Now, like I said, I'm not talking about their relationship, because even if we go deeper in that, she spoke on, there was ifs, ands, and buts about the character of the man. That should have been a red flag where you're like, okay, you're definitely not going to give full access to my email that's connected to my business. However, I don't want to focus on the relationship. I want to keep it focused on the business aspect. You do not give anyone access to any of your business tools at all, full access at all. Because as you grow in business, you're going to have to hire people to help you out with the business. That's the only way you're going to grow. So they're going to need some access to something. However, the key word is limited access. If she would have given him limited access to her email, because from what she said, he helped out with the business, which is fine, get limited access to the email, she would be able to still access her email and reach out to her customers, do damage control, make sure personally she's reaching out to her customers. She's reaching out to her customer through social media, that's great. However, there's people that's just not gonna care. And that alone, what he's doing could ruin her brand. However, I think she has a strong enough brand to come back from that, but not everyone is that lucky. So before we even get into the part of where we have to do damage control, try to protect yourself. Protect your business by all costs. It does not take a lot of money. As a matter of fact, it really doesn't take much money at all, especially when you're starting off. You be that 100% access to any of your tools, especially your email if it's connected to your business. Your email is connected to your bank accounts. Your email is connected to the platform that the customers are purchasing from, how they respond back to you. I mean, it is so important for us business people out there to take these things seriously and not think that, hey, this person, you know, sounds good, so you just take it on over. No, because anything could happen. And it could be someone who's actually even from the outside who could hack into your email. We're not talking about that. We're talking about what you can control. We're not talking about hackers. We're not talking about somebody came to your house and spied on your password or anything like that. We're talking about what you could control yourself. That is what I want to make sure I emphasize on, doing whatever we can to protect our business. And that is a simple thing that we could do, not giving anyone full access to our email that is connected to our business. And that is my take from it. I hope that you guys enjoy my take from it. And I want to know if you guys feel that it was the right decision for her to do, to give her boyfriend full access to her email account that's connected to the business. Please comment below and let me know that. I really want to know what your thoughts on that is. And also comment below and let me know if you guys feel that there should be other ways that we give limited access to people who are helping us in our business. Comment below and let me know that. Thanks guys for tuning in. I've got more of my two cents in entrepreneurial and business that I'm gonna bring to you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this content. And once again, shout out to Mercy Gunu. I enjoy your channel and I enjoy the hard work. You are a hardworking person and kudos to you. And I hope that if someone shares this with you, if this could be an inspiration to you of moving forward, what to do. Just one thing that, you know, you would have in the hindsight learned. Thanks again, guys. Talk to you later.